Hello friends of the Northern Entertainment and welcome to another episode of Derail Valley. Yeah, you haven't seen anything of that in a while, but there is a new update, and that update is the overhaul update. And to be honest with you, the overhaul update is not an update per se. It is a re-innovation, if you will. The game is really reinventing itself. And what I mean by that is here alone in the career manager, you can see that already. If we just go here quickly to the licenses, the train driver is of course the basic one. The DE2 is the license for the little shunter. But then we have the DE6, which is the big diesel, and that is a $200,000 ticket. And then we have the 282, which is of course the steamer, and that's a $50,000 ticket. Concurrent jobs, one is 10,000, two is 20,000. The train length, two is another 20,000. Then the hazmat licenses are crazy expensive, let alone the military licenses. So you need to have pretty deep pockets to get through this game. That being said, I have played this a little bit. Well, actually a lot on streams. And so got us a little bit ahead here. What we do have is, as you can see here, we have the remote or the belt pack, as it is called. And it is, from what I understand, somewhat prototypical. Of course, it's not 100%. It can't be. But it's definitely here for us to use. And with that said, we are right now, where are we? I think we are at Machine Factory. I might be wrong. Let me check that. Is that a military base? Yeah, there is a military base. So I'm almost certain we are right now at Machine Factory, but we can... Shunting, yes, Machine Factory. Load and prepare a train with excavators for departure. And that one goes then to Iron Ore Mine West. So, this is our shunting job manual. And that tells us that we have to grab the car CFF077 from track B6S. And then we connect the car CFF698, 825, and 077, where we will... Oh, wait a second. Never mind. So I skipped one. Sorry. So 698 and 825 will be connected to one of our shunters. And the shunters are... Where did I park it? I think one should be right there. Yes, haha, there it is. Beauty. Okay, let's just see here. This wants to go here. There is a certain order that I like to have. My radio I like to have on two, and my remote I like to have on one. So we need the track C2 Sierra. This is B. I think the C are over here. C2 Sierra is this one, and I do believe this is actually, yeah, there's 475 and here is 875. So you're gonna see a lot of things that are new in the game that I don't have to, like, where I can just show you rather than tell you that they are new. And one of them of course is this here. And this, if you are in North America, might look very foreign to you, just because we use knuckles up here. But that is not the case for this. This is, of course, here an interesting train. If I run into that one too fast, then we would have somewhat of a... let's see if we... we're gonna grab one train from B6S, so... You know what? We might as well grab that one first, I think. think that's a good idea. And we might also have to turn around, but we'll see. Clickety clickety click, and she's a running. How's our Fuelio? Fuelio, 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 fuel good. That's good, that's good, that's good. Alright. We don't need to worry about the fan at this point. So yeah, we are going to grab that car on the B6S first. That seems to make the most sense to me anyway. But yeah, there have been a whole bunch of improvements made. So, and lights will come as a working add-on later on. For right now. Bell is coming as well. I talked already to the developers about that because I was curious. In a situation like this here where we are working in the harbor, that would be definitely a situation where, for the sake of safety, we would run with a bell. There we go. Now our belt pack is activated, and also now our belt pack is activated as well as paired with the locomotive. And whoop. Beauty. Could I please? And thank you. Thank you. Let's open up the angle cock. There we go. That's all done. Wonderful. Now we can head on out. And grab those other cars. On Charlie 2S. But yeah, there is a ton of improvements. Of course, the addition of speed signs, as you can see here, as well as the addition of signs that show you the gradient that you have to deal with, are really nice. And helpful. And then of course the addition of hazmat in and of itself, as well as military stuff that you can see here, which is most likely going boom if you hit it too hard. And all these things. Oops. Mistakes have been made. I hit accidentally the wrong button. But stuff like that happens. The thing is, it is really expensive if you damage your locomotive, and you can really damage your locomotive. The nice thing is that there are a couple of little gadgets that help you now. Namely, if you'll take the radio, see, you can go crew vehicle, you can go aim at the vehicle you wish to remove, re-rail, switch, and so on and so forth. And this sign here, they have to change. Charlie 2S? There's Charlie 2S. And this is why I love the belt pack. In fact, we don't even have to be on the train now for this little operation. We can, in theory, just stand here beside the loading crane and monitor the whole operation from here. I should be able to catch that switch. I want to slow down a little bit. And boop. There we go. Wonderful. And we're going to hook that up. And then we're gonna go ahead here, make sure that we grab the right cars, which is .077. Oh, what? Oh, don't tell me. .698. Really? Huh. Well, it could have been a really easy operation. Emphasis here on could have. Okay, what we're going to do is, let me see here, how much room do I have here? Okay, and that's how many? So those are the last two, that means one. You two. Gonna stay here. Yeah, they are already disconnected. The 4443. Just trying to think here. It's the easiest. Well, you know what? The smartest way to do this. Let's do the following. This way I should really get into the habit of. Oh, this is why I should get into the habit of. Checking. Oops. This is what happens when you put the train into emergency. There we go. So what we do now is we're gonna push this pull this wagon back. Push it on the loading rack. And then we're gonna go ahead and just make our way past all these wagons on the other side. And then we are going to push them in from the other side here. That's the easiest way to do this, I think. So once he is... So once the last axle is past the switch... I'm just gonna go ahead here. Oh yeah, what I should tell you guys... about this game as well, of course, is in case you don't know that if you have VR, this game is actually made for VR, or it's made with VR in mind. I haven't tried that yet. I definitely will try it though, just not today. Speed of 7, that's good enough to get on board. Honestly, this is the most fun, really, of doing, or when you can do shunting like that. That's definitely the nicest way to do it. You can also kick cars, and if you don't know what that means, I will absolutely show you that. I'll make sure that the angle cock is closed. So just like I said, we're gonna go and go via rail for Sierra. Oh, sorry, Sierra, what is it? Charlie 4, I... Oh, wait. That was too early. Yeah, okay. We need the other one as well. I don't know why I forgot about that, but hey. See, this is the one that I had to change. Actually, I might as well be a little bit more. Because we have places to be. Now we're gonna go back here. Over this one. Over this one. And I do believe... Ah, perfect. Look at that. Now we're gonna back into Charlie to Sierra. And we'll then couple to those two wagons and bring them to the loading dock as well, which is actually ideal because that puts us exactly into the position that we need to be to depart the factory. I'm not sure where they want us to Charlie 1L, and then it goes to track B50. And from B50, not in this episode, but probably in the next, or in the next stream, we will take those and deliver them to the machine factory. Oh, sorry, to Iron Ore Mist. Yeah. Exactly. There we go. Three-point protection is in place. So it is safe for us. There we go. And I'm gonna assume my position back here. Making sure that everything is done. We're gonna do one last check. This is 698. And the other one should be 825, which is the case. Alright. So, you are ready. Actually, you know what? Yeah, no, I might not be able to catch those from here, so that's okay. That is all good. And Bravo 6S is all the way over there. So we're just gonna pull on ahead a little bit more then. And bring it over. This is Bravo 2. Bravo 6S is, I'm pretty sure, the one on the very end. Ah, here we go. Stop! Oh, what's going on now? Hello? Oh, right. Should maybe have the belt pack out to use it. That would help. But that's all good. Feeling? Ah. All right. So, there. Silly car. I'll be running away. There we go. Perfect. All right. This is, by the way, why you make sure that the 3-point protection is in place. So that doesn't happen. Okay, I have the feeling I forgot one of the anger cogs because... No, I forgot them both. That is pretty sad. Alright, let's load this quickly. There we go. Oh, wow. I do have the feeling that this is going to be heavier than what our poor little loco can can do for us. Okay, we are still building up brake pressure. Soon. I'm gonna double check the angle cocks here again because something is not right. No? Oh, let's see if this one is closed or open. No, this one is closed too, so we should be good. Well, except for that this is not hooked in, but that doesn't really matter. Ah, be that as it may, I'm gonna just stay back here. And we are going to look for B6 Sierra. Oh. Safety first. Awesome. Alright. By the way, I've seen this, what I'm doing right now, done many, many times in real life. Just like that. Which I wonder. And let me know that in the comments below if you happen to be a railroader in the States. If you, well, I guess you wouldn't do that because the system is a little bit different, but I've seen that in Germany done great many times where they would stand beside the buffers. And yeah, would receive the train as such. Which, to be honest with you, is a little bit unnerving, I would say. I mean, this is a... I guess nothing can really happen, but... it is a little bit unnerving. Get that all connected up. This time... we are good to go. Our last move, or our last two movements for this episode. Mm-hmm. I'm actually surprised how well this worked. It's so nice to see, though, that those intermodals are now really colorful and have different advertisements on them as well. Six, yeah, six is the one on the very end there. 5 minutes. So yeah, there you can see it. 6 Sierra is the very outbound one. It's kind of what I figured. So this is now our switch here that we need. This very one. And now, we just have to make our way all the way to the outside. This is another one of those signs that has to be replaced. Out. Out. And... ah! Out. Okay. Perfect. This will now let us go all the way to the outside. As you can see, there is Bravo 40, Bravo 50. And this is gonna get us directly to 6 Sierra. Anybody need a tractor? You can get them in every color as long as it's red. And we are here. Now I'm just gonna turn off the engine because fuel or diesel is rather an expensive commodity. So now I'm just gonna do a quick port over to the shop. No, wait, not to the shop, to the, I have to go to the office, so that's down here. And there we will evaluate our job performance, like so. And that tells us. That tells us that I had to go to 5 Oscar, which I will do, but not today. This is the end for now. And I will talk to you guys again soon. Thanks for watching. Northern Alex signing off.